Taratara. Voodoo Beats. Ευλαμπία. Τι άλλο θέλεις άρθω να σου πω. Hello, Kyo-san. How are you doing? I'm okay. But my chat box is not. Chat box. Let me try to fix the fucking chat box. Come on. Yeah. Hello, Evlabia. Yeah. How are you doing, Agile? And also Kyo-san. I think it is working now. Ring of Glory, Ring of Will, Health Regen, Restore, Ring of Will, Ring of Health Restore, Effortlessness, Ring of Luck, Ring of Will, Ring of Glory, Will Energy, useless. You are very good, Kyo-san. Oh, this is awesome. If you are very good, this is awesome. Kyo-san, is your therapy over? This one that you said that you had. With vitamin C, if I'm not mistaken. Trying to overlay your video on top of my TQ Play screen. Agile, I don't know if you can do this with Titan Quest. I don't know. This music is amazing. It is absolutely, totally awesome. Horus Eyes. Let's go there. Ta ra ta ra ta 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 ra ta ta ra ta ta ra ta ta ra ta 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 ra ta ta. Zoom out a little bit. I was laughing with the Japanese industry at that videos. The therapy is for the next month and a half, the injections were less frequent only. Aha. Why? What happened with the Japanese industry? Actually, Kyo-san, I remembered that I was reading some news yesterday about Elite Dangerous. You know, I think you recommended this game to me back, I think, a year ago. They are working on a new expansion for that game, which has been called Odyssey. And in that with that expansion, you can go And you can take a character, your character, yourself out of your spaceship. And you can go walk on planets and explore planets with a character, if you were playing Mass Effect, for example, or something. So now it becomes also a third-person action game as well. Do you know this news? Hello, Ray Swords. How are you today, Ray? Okay, where do I have to go for this quest? Interior courtyard of Seth's palace. Wait. Desert of Avidos. Okay, I have to go to the Desert of Avidos. So let's go to Swords of... Swords of Philae. From the Swords of Philae, I will go to the Desert of Avidos. This is the Act of Egypt, and I have finished the first act, which was Greek Act. In this game, there is no specific order. The first act of the game is it depends on the class you choose. If you choose the Greek character, this one, then the first act is Greek Act. If you choose Egyptian class, then the first act is Egypt Act. Adult video industry aka porn. They were making new movies that mostly mock the idiotic behavior of feminists. I heard about it ages, but I haven't had the time to search about it yet. Yeah, chaos on it. I was thinking, maybe it is the right time now to start playing and learning that game, because it is awesome. But I don't know how to play that game. Dave, no. Kyo-san is not in therapy because of women. He has another problem, which is related to vitamin B12, whatever. Bam 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 para bam 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 para bam bam. Sort of go. Oh, nice hit. Thank you. Nice, a blue bow. A health potion. Is the music of the game loud, guys? Do you want me to increase it? I picked my old save, currently level 51-52. From what I figured, spending gold to increase faith is only used for so much gold. Wait, how do you spend gold to increase faith? You spend items, you offer items to increase faith, not gold. Can you spend gold to increase faith? Sound levels for game music and voice are all good. Oh, nice. Yes, get items from soul. Ah, okay, yeah. Yeah, okay. Yes, you can do this. Nice. Da-da-da-da. No, Chaosan, this is the game's max to zoom out. This one, this is the max to zoom in. I have it about here because I want the graphics to be a bit bigger. If you want, you can zoom out. Okay, when you play Ratchet bit, it's better to zoom out totally because you can shoot enemies from farther away. Chinese MMO Titan Quest? No, first of all, it is not MMO. It is single player or multiplayer. Yeah, multiplayer, I don't think it works now. It is offline single player game. It has multiplayer, but I don't know if it works. And it is not Chinese either. The Cyanide Studios studio made this game, company. I think those people are European, I don't remember. Or the studio at least. I have these two items, the shield and the weapon. These two items are unique items. And the good thing is that this shield provides more... wait. Increased chance to fight more powerful items. Which means magic fight for better items. You know, higher tier of items. Thank you. UI and placement of enemies. No, I wouldn't say that, no. Hello, Adrian Risky. Welcome to the stream. Yet one more stream. Do you like this music? This is one of my favorite tracks in the game. Music tracks. Come on, game. Don't crash. The game provides the ability to play the classes differently than the norm, like your two-handed attack summons on Diablo 2. Yeah, look, the build diversity of this game is very big. Maybe it is better than Diablo 2, because in Diablo 2 I can play the Amazon with a two-handed attack. But... it is not the best way to play Amazon, because I'm not sure, I don't remember the details of Diablo 2, but I think that different types of weapons in Diablo 2, they provide different amounts of, for example, chance to hit to different classes. It does things like that, basic mechanics like that, chance to hit, maybe attack speed, I don't know. In which case, this means that a two-handed attack Amazon in Diablo 2 will never be as good as an Amazon which uses an item, a type of weapon that is that the class is made for. For example, Amazon in Diablo 2 is mostly made for bows and spears. This is it. The game is almost same like Titan Quest. It is very, very similar to Titan Quest, but it has big differences as well. I mean, it doesn't restrict your... No, Kyo-san, this game is... it probably provides even more build diversity than Diablo 2. You have your attribute point system here, you can put points in different things. For example, you can put points on dexterity to increase your chance to hit enemies. With strength you increase your physical damage output. Yeah, these are generic ones, we could say. And you have many, many different types of items. There are some class-specific items in the game, I think. Let me see. Yeah, there are class-specific... There are class-specific items. But for example, with the Amazon, you can play with a bow, you can play with a spear, you can play with a sword and a shield, you can play with a mace, you can play with a hammer, you can play with an axe, everything, almost. It is a very deep game. This is not the problem of the game. This game has no problems when it comes to depth. It only has problems with bugs and especially quality of life improvements. It needs quality of life improvements. And of course, bug fixing. Hello, Yosef. I had a friend who played Assassin Diablo 2 and he took no abilities because he could get more stats. He finished the game with just a 200 attacks. Nice. Dave, did she finish the game in Hell difficulty, which is the third highest level of difficulty? I never asked at the time. Okay. Come on, bug. Why is the Amazon blue? Because I'm wearing items, this armor, which is, it is not blue, it is something like silver. Silver blue. That makes her look like blue. Ta-da-da. The Amazon should be able to use swords or other thrust weapons, but doesn't make sense that the barbarian would be equal with skill with javelins as the Amazon. He's a brute with no finesse. Maybe. What the hell with this bug now? Come on, pick up the fucking I don't know. Yeah, this is a bug. It will not allow me to pick up these items. Come on, game. What have I done to you? Don't torture me like this. Oh, he liked how he died. Whoa! There was 10 unique items. You see, if those items are blue, they are not unique. Unique items, let me show you, are these ones. The orange ones. The destroyer of forest. By the way, I found this axe twice. These are unique items. This is one of the unique tiers of items. Because you have this color of unique items, the orange one. Then you have heroic items. I think green items are heroic. You have red items. Those items are mythic, mythical. And you have yellow items. Those items are divine. But as far as I remember, at least, to have divine items dropping, you have to reach the level cap of the game, which is 200. I think of the barbarian as present, not British. Brutus. The barbarian swift, light in his feet, it hits like a truck in my mind anyway. Well, who knows, maybe, you know, maybe there are different kinds of barbarians. These are chaos golems. This is Seth's titan. This is a titan of Seth. You know, Seth is the ancient Egyptian god of Egyptian god, which was renamed to Satan, and now he became the devil of Christian mythology. Let me pick up the... I mean, imagine now if the game will drop... Ah! I picked them up. This game is 13 years old. It was released back in 2007 when Immortal Throne of Titan Quest Expansion was released. I would say that this game is the only true Titan Quest clone on this planet. Squats. Now you must do a squat every time the character dies a squat. If I do this, Dave, I will be dead before the stream. The stream ends. You can see the budget difference. Yeah. Yes, this is true. There is a very, very big difference in quality. Titan Quest is much higher quality in general. But this game is also me because of the features of the game, and the music is top notch. Oh! All of my arrows missed these enemies. These enemies were very lucky. Strength, shrine, spine. You can see that the bugs are everywhere in this game. Thankfully, the bugs are very small. We are not talking about game-breaking bugs. But still, the bugs are everywhere. I cannot believe how much they are not ashamed of themselves selling such a buggy game. Come on, pick up the fucking items, fucking game, fuck your life tonight. Don't give me unique. Yes. Έλα. Ε. Γε. Come on. Ε. It will not give me these items. Bugs are everywhere, a true Titan Quest clone. No, the Titan Quest doesn't have so many bugs. Those enemies look like Thanos. Yeah, maybe. Hello to you, Atropov. Yeah, I don't know how you spell your name. No all pickup. Dave, this is the all pickup. Take all, it says take all. It is only that this map now is bugged. Maybe if I reload to the game and come to this map, it will work fine. But I'm not going to do that. Wait, why is this thing blue? I see something blue there. I agree to Xeo's bug, we shall see each other soon. Yosef, yeah, we don't have a problem with inventory. Maybe the reward is to pick one of the three chests. I legit think they look like Thanos. Yeah. Anyway, let's talk to this guy and get out of here.
You have already found Osiris's arms that lay within Set's palace. There are three.
Yeah, now what? Pointless. Hello, Kostsan. How are you doing? How the hell am I supposed to go up there? Ψυχή, yeah. The game was patched, and I remember that the game received about maybe 7 patches. Maybe 4 to 7, I think about 7 patches. And the bugs are still there. It is a big shame because I like this game very, very, very much. I could have given up Titan Quest for this game. And I'm talking about today. How do I go there? Somehow I have to get out of here at... You will never give up on Titan Quest. Yeah, unfortunately this is true.
Thank you.
Seth's Titan. At least I was able to pick up these items. How the hell can I go there now? No, there is no this way. Why, unfortunately? I don't know. I just wanted to make it sound dramatic. Actually, I was thinking today, maybe you remember, guys, I guess, that I started working little by little on a Titan Quest book, right? Hello, Stinkep. I had a very, very great idea today. What if I make this book, but first, to make a version, at least the first version of the book, to be a digital version, but to be an interactive book. What does this mean? It will not be just a PDF where it has pages and you read the book. It will be something like a game or something like a program, a tool, something like that. It will be interactive. And I thought that this idea is actually great. I like it very much. Loot got fixed. What loot? Hello, Artorias. Developers are supporting it less and less because they concentrate on making it on every platform instead of clearing bugs. This is true. Actually, consoles have killed the Titan Quest on PC. I have to admit that this is the reality of things now. Sikep, of course I will use Game Maker. I mean, I'm also thinking to maybe sometimes live stream myself trying to learn on Game Maker. Okay, I found my way. Whoa. In my opinion, this type of games doesn't fit well in consoles. Yeah, because now imagine, for example, some company or the people that created this game, Loki, to try to make this game console friendly. I mean, it is the same thing as the Titan Quest. You have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 10 hotkeys, a slot bar of 10 hotkeys. When you get games like these, deep games, it is not the best thing to convert them to console games. But anyway, it makes sense because this company is a company, it is a business, they want to make money. I mean, this makes sense, there is nothing wrong with that. And they thought that releasing the game on consoles, it would bring them profits. Which I hope it did, and it will keep doing, but the problem is that this game is actually a PC, not this one, Titan Quest, is actually a PC game, and they have to give priority to PC. And at least fix the fucking bugs. This game deserves to be lofted patch. Think about you're talking about Loki. Because yes, I mean, I cannot believe that the company that created this game, and also Steam, they keep selling the game on Steam and they feel no shame. because the game is in a beta state, if not an alpha state. It is buggy and it needs quality of life improvements and optimization to be in a state where you can sell the game. Of course, I don't think they make any money, any true, real money from this game, because who buys this game? But how do you expect to sell a game if, first of all, you the game you do not support the game when the game is not in a good state to sell it at the first in the first time? They have to fix the bugs. Diablo 3 was a success of consoles. Καλησπέρα, Jadens. They should sell the IP to me. Stickave, do you think you could fix the game? Oh, nice hit. Come on, the bug is still here, what the hell? Yes, really, stinker. Jadens, I'm talking about this game, Loki. The game I'm playing right now. This game is in a beta state right now, if not in an alpha state. The bugs are everywhere. You start the game and you meet bugs instantly, almost. And right now I have this bug. For example, I click here and this window goes away and I cannot pick up the items. I have to click very fast twice, double click on the bug to be able to take the items, and sometimes I cannot get them. This is a sudden bug that started happening about 10 minutes ago. Go figure. With a game like Titan Quest, not so noticeable, they should have stick to PC at least the little people that play it. Those black scorpions look similar with the ones in Titan Quest. Maybe. This game sure does have a lot of enemies to kill. Yeah. Texture bugs, loading bugs, it is totally buggy. But it is awesome. It is awesome. You can still play and enjoy the game, but you will have to deal with the bugs all the time. See, I cannot. Desert of Avidos, let's go pick up. Yeah, but how can I pick up the item though? It is not working. This is the evil mummy. Mummy. They should make a new XRPG called Bugs. If people complain, they will never know. Very good, thank you day for me today. I got Key of Elysium. Ah, nice! Albadi, γεια σου! Στην υγειά σου! Ψυχή, this game doesn't crash very often. The crashes are very infrequent. Like the monster infrequent items of Titan Quest. I'm not complaining about crashes of this game. Yes, they can happen. But crashes are very rare. My inventory is full. Lalus again. Are you feeling fat again, Lalus? First game called Bugs, then Expansion Bugs, Rise of the Bugs. And then the second expansion will be called Salad of Bugs. Now it works! I mean, go figure. Let's see, is it going to work again? My attacking speed with these items is very bad. No, it doesn't work. Oh! You are still feeling medium fat. Starship Troopers, that is a bug crashing game. Yeah, I know nothing about that. This game's music is fucking beautiful. Stickab, this game's music is a masterpiece. It is absolutely awesome. This is Fratov. I cannot pick up the items. At least give me this item, the quest. This is a quest item. Let me pick up Orusai. Yeah. It will not give me the Horus Eye. Ah! I picked it up! Nice. You are 95 kilos and 190. You are just a little bit fat. 5 kilos fat? You are not fat, you are okay. Wait, what? But I picked up the item. Wait. Yeah. What is that? Yes, there is one more. Yes! Okay. Desert of Avidos. Let's see. I have to go and bring this item back to ISIS. So, exit the game because the game is buggy right now. And restart. This is not Witcher, I will only watch Witcher stream. Yeah, buddy. I have uninstalled Witcher. But, Albadi, I will install Witcher 2 and I will try Witcher 2 next week. I don't, I just feel fat. Don't feel fat. Yeah, I mean, Albadi, look. I paid about, I think, 3 euros because for Witcher 1 and 2 together in a bundle. It was on sale. Or maybe 3-4 euros, or maybe 5. The maximum 5. I played Witcher 1 3 hours. Okay, let's suppose that I paid 2.5 euros for Witcher 1 and 2.5 euros for Witcher 2. So, I played 3 hours of Witcher 1, which means 2.5 euros. I got my money's worth, because 3 hours, 2.5 euros for 3 hours of entertainment is awesome. It is very cheap. So, I will repeat the same with Witcher 2. I will get my money's worth out of Witcher 2 as well. 3 hours of playtime is okay. And everything is fine. There is no argument, people say they are fat, skinny or so, and just enjoy life. So you liked Witcher after all? 50% yes, I liked it 50%. Or maybe 40%. Now I cannot even... Even the inventory is not working, what the fuck, I mean... Exit the game totally. What the fuck? And they sell this fucking game. They have no shame. They sell this game. Oh, this world is... Did I hear you will play Witcher 2? Yes, yes, Psyche, I will. Maybe next week. Maybe. They sell much more buggy games than this, why so they should be ashamed of? It doesn't matter. If there are more buggy games than this one, it matters not. What matters is that now it works. Each studio that has made a game to support the game to fix the fucking bugs. This is what matters. Now, just because some other companies have created buggy games and they are selling buggy games, this is not an excuse for every other company to be selling buggy games. This is Goddess Isis, by the way. Eh? Goddess I... Eh? The Goddess? Eh? The Goddess? The Goddess? The Goddess? This is a mature game, it is a game. I am back in BR3 again, I saw it is there for DLC for today. Nice! You are eating Greek? What Greek food? I like the design of this game, sure there are bugs, but imagine if it was fixed. Yeah, but it will never get fixed, I think. And then it happens, yes. What can you do? Screenshots, screenshots! Can you zoom more? I am zooming more. Oh! I mean, she is a goddess. She is a goddess. Oops. She is a goddess. No clothes bug. Hello, Messiah. Where is the log? I have to go back to Seth's tomb. Okay, let's go back to Seth's tomb. Where is Seth's tomb? Male instincts activated. Comet sexual activity increased by 5000%. Which character's class begins in Egypt? There are four classes. One is the Greek fighter, which is the one I'm playing. It starts in Greece. One is the Norse male character, which starts in Norway, somewhere up there, I don't remember where. One is the Aztec class, which starts in Native America places, I don't remember where. And the fourth and final class is Egyptian class, which is a male class, and it starts in Egypt. Lalus, there are more goddesses and gods in this game, yeah. We have Athena, which is in Greece, the goddess Athena. I don't remember if we have in other places as well. Critical damage, bitch! It didn't give me a unique item. I was hoping for a unique. You love very much the soundtrack of this game. Yeah, it is one of the best. What? I am doing Athena building Titan quest now. Nice. Yeah, we have Athena in Greece here in this game. The goddess Athena. Yosef the Mighty is one of the gods. She's one of the Radon, Gunner Operative, Beastmaster Siren. Albadi, Beastmaster. You have... Guys, I think I found the game with which I will replace Titan Quest. That game is going to be... Next build builds based on Vikings, Gods and Titan Quest, eh? I played Titan Quest and I found a potion in chest that gives me about... Yes. No, no, you cannot buy this potion on a Messiah, you can only find it by drops. And it is very, very rare, you cannot believe how rare it is. It is very rare. So, save it. For the character that you are sure you want to max out and use it later, much later. Hello, Spirit Rider. Can you tame women in this game? No. The Mist, no God of all your sin. What? Yeah, you just found it. Yes, it is very, very rare. You found it because you were very, very lucky. Imagine, since last year when Atlantis DSC was released, I haven't found more than 5 experience potions. And you know, I have played many, many thousands of hours since last year. What game will replace Titan Quest? Silverfall? No. The game is going to be... Ta-taan! No game at all. fight the top half of Osiris' body. Can you make a goddess date you? Lalouz, you cannot because this game is not Sims. Fire the troll. I'm not trolling. Out with it, buddy. But I'm not trolling. I'm telling the truth. I heard about replacing TQ. This is first degree crime. Yeah, it is.
Pharaoh has arrived in the...
What game? What game? What do you mean, what game? Let's go this way. Popo Sims 2 was awesome back in the day. They are making super hot goddesses and you can't do anything with them. Yeah. Wait, what's replacing Titan Quest? Dirts, I'm going to replace Titan Quest as a main game with another game. And people were asking me which game is going to be, and I told them that it is going to be not a game at all. Yeah, think it, not a game at all. Okay, question to everybody. Which game would you like me to replace Titan Quest with? Are you going to be a singing streamer now? Nope, I'm not a singer. I know with what you're gonna replace it. You're gonna replace Titan Quest with more Titan Quest. You will be replacing it with Anniversary, Ragnarok and Atlantis. Instead of TQ, he will dance naked in the rain. Torchlight 3. Replace Titan Quest with even more Titan Quest, please. Last Epoch has a vision. Yeah, Last Epoch, I think, to be honest, I think that Last Epoch can hit directly Path of Exile. It can become the biggest competitor of Path of Exile. At least before Diablo 4 comes out, because after Diablo 4 comes out, everything is dead. Dead. Not really dead, but dead. But yeah, Last Epoch could be that game. Albadi, please show us. Yeah. Torchlight is cool. Can you show me player inventory and skill menu? This is the inventory of the in this game. In this game, Grim Dawn, fuck Last Epoch. I don't think I will ever go back to Grim Dawn. I mean, wait, guys, wait. I cannot replace Titan Quest with Grim Dawn. Why? Because if I do this, Grim Dawn will always be reminding me of Titan Quest, and I cannot have this. I cannot do it. It is going to be torture. Grim Dawn is amazing, but we are looking at the future here. Exactly, there is, yeah. So, this is the inventory. The inventory is different than other games. I wouldn't say it is better because I like having the classic inventory of Titan Quest where I can see straight away all of my items because all items have 2D icons in the inventory of Titan Quest, and you can move the items wherever you like. This inventory is different. It is a list of the items that you have picked up. But this one is actually better. Why? Because you can pick up and hold hundreds of items, and I'm talking about big items as well. You cannot do this in the classic inventory types of Diablo, Titan Quest, Grim Dawn, and whatnot. So, from a management perspective, this is the best inventory ever made in action RPG games. From a yeah, from a, I don't know, from a perspective of picking up the items and moving them in the inventory, inside your inventory, this one is useless. But it doesn't matter because you can still see the items. These items are unique, by the way, these two. It is the same item, I have found the same item twice. Unique item. Great double axe, two-handed axe. You have armor items here, different list. All of these are different items. And you can see down here it says a number, it says 44. This is how many items your weapons inventory can hold. Not all of the, your whole inventory. Your weapons inventory right now can hold 44 items. Your armor inventory can hold 44 items. So right now you can have 44 plus 44, 88 items. Big items, small items, whatever. Your objects inventory can hold 84 items! 84 items! 84 items! Plus 88 items, it is 172. Wait, is it so, yeah. So, Titan Quest is bad games. 174, 88 and 84 is 162, 8 and 4 is 12, 81, 72, yeah. So, yeah, this game has some awesome features, as I said before. Ah, also the skills. this is the skill tree. Yeah, it is my face up there, you cannot see very well the skill tree anyway. You select, these are three different skill trees. I have selected the Artemis skill tree and I'm using this skills, I'm playing with these skills. But you can mix and match if you go different skill trees, but to do this, you have to activate a different skill tree. And when you gain experience which is faith for skills only, and experience for your character. Style like Titan Quest is okay, but Titan Quest like a Skyrim or Witcher is very annoying. Maybe, yeah. Good bow builds get nerfed. Maybe. Why do you want to replace TQ in the first place? Are you reaching a stage that you have to play it far too much? It's TK, but I'm not going to replace Titan Quest. The only reason for me to replace Titan Quest with something else would be to do something that would probably give me a chance, one chance to increase this channel, to grow this channel. Because with Titan Quest this channel will never grow. If you want to grow your channel, you have to go popular. You have to go with popular games and or whatever you do with something popular, mainstream. But I'm not going to do that. Ah, now it works, okay. Which means one day all of these things will be over. Videos will be over, streams will be over, everything will be over. I will go to jail. Blizzard is going after money, they don't care if hardcore PC games are pleased. Nah, I will not play Minecraft. You can play something popular, but you love Titan Quest too much. Yeah. I dumped way too much time into Path of Exile. This channel is a qualitative one, small but strong. Yeah, Yosef, but you cannot keep doing this forever. Oh! Two blue items. You could stream Diablo 4 when released, many people should fight you. Valkyrina, if I will be here when Diablo 4 releases, and if the game will be good, and if I will be making videos at least at that point, then yes, I will make content of Diablo 4, because I will play Diablo 4. I mean, even if I didn't have this channel, I would still play Diablo 4 if the game, if I would like the game. My plan is not to play Diablo 4 because I have this channel going on. I would play Diablo 4 either way. Question: Grim Dawn or Titan Quest? Titan Quest, come on, Grim Dawn. A Battle Royale mode like Fortnite, Titan Quest would be great. Fuck Diablo 3. Who said anything about Diablo 3? Witcher 1 is a game dead game too. Yeah. This is why I stick up next week. I'll play Witcher 2. I have already uninstalled Witcher 1. I'd love to see a Unity or Unreal remake of Diablo 1. Yes, SB, this would be totally mind-blowing. What is a milestone you want to reach in terms of growth? See, in terms of growth, there is no milestone. You have to decide to make some decisions. Do you want this thing? Not me personally, in general. Why are you doing this? I started doing this thing as a hobby. But then I saw that there is a possibility, maybe a small one, for this thing to become bigger than a hobby and maybe to make it a part-time job, maybe. Or even a full-time job, why not? So many people have managed to turn their hobby to profession. And since I enjoy very much making videos in general, and content, and live streams, it is one of my hobbies. Even when I was making, I didn't even back in the day, for example 15 years ago, when I didn't even have internet, or I didn't, there was no YouTube, I was making videos and I was watching the videos I was making for myself. And I have the box up there, the Music Maker Deluxe, 11 version Deluxe, which is, I bought it back in 2005, I think. It is a music software, but it allows you to make videos as well, not high quality videos, but back then it was a hobby. I was making videos just to pass some time, to be creative. I wasn't making videos for YouTube or something like this. So yeah, when it comes to growth, you have to decide, do you want to do it as a hobby? You don't care. If you do it as a hobby, you don't care about growth so much. But at some point you cannot keep spending so many hours on something that is a hobby. You have to decide. You either do it as a hobby and you reduce the hours because you have to do real life stuff, or you take this thing one level higher, you do it as a part-time job, if not a full-time job, and in this case everything changes. Then your goal, your milestone as growth is to go as high as possible. There is no, when you start a business, when you do something to get money, you do not say, okay, I will do something that will give me 100 euros and I'm fine, this is my milestone. There is no milestone. You try to grow all the time, all the time. You try to do the best you can. So there is no milestone. But if I truly wanted right now to replace Titan Quest, I would do it only for this reason. Because with Titan Quest, Titan Quest Vanilla pre-nerf Konku was beast. Dun, 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 dun. This music is so awesome. I never get bored of the music of this game. I watch you stream in midnight, really. So you are saying it's still a hobby for you. Sihi, I cannot stay. I mean, I cannot. I would like for this thing to become at least a part-time job to reach that level, but it is not happening. These enemies deal so much damage. They are burning my ass. Opa. Wait, what? Give me a unique item, come on. Oh, hope! Hope! Hope is a quest item. I just picked up hope. I think Titan Quest has reached the dead. I don't think we will get more DLC or such. Stinkab, yes, I also don't think a DLC will come. Are you Spanish or English? I'm not Spanish or English, I'm Greek. Yeah, Yosef, did you see this bird? It was awesome. Hello, Wallen. Titan Quest will not reach the dead while there are mothers for it. Look, Lalos, when we say a game is dead, we are talking about official support. We are not talking about the game itself, you know. I mean, even Skyrim is alive, even Morrowind is alive. There is a modding community that makes mods for Morrowind. People play Morrowind. And I'm also thinking to live stream Morrowind, maybe at least once, maybe one day, I don't know. Gothic games are not dead because some people play Gothic games. But when we say games are dead, we are talking about official support. For example, Diablo 1 is dead. Why? Are there no people playing the game? No. Many people play that game. And especially mods of the game. There are some modders that make new mods for the game. But when it comes to the official support, there is no official support. The game is dead. Zedens, are you 60 years old? Gothic is definitely dead. A very popular game is called Subnautica, very good. I know, I was watching a live stream, I think, a couple of days ago. A little bit of that game. But you know, I want games that have depth and super duper replayability, such as Titan Quest, for example. Or this game. I wouldn't replace Titan Quest with something like Subnautica. Last thing was once it gets its full release as a fresh game, more people will be watching streams, you might be able to attract them and then it's a part-time job. Yeah, this is a theory. But to be honest, guys, my plans have changed when it comes to YouTube. When you guys say the game is dead, it sounds like you're saying no one is playing it and no one works on it. Okay, when I say it is dead, I'm not referring to these things. I'm talking about official support. I mean, even Daggerfall, Elder Scrolls Daggerfall is not dead. Because there are people that make mods of that game and some people play the game. Actually, Jaden's 79 is 82 years old. Okay. How do you like Loki so far? Look, this is not the first time I play this game. The first time was back in 2007. This game is awesome. It is buggy. It has many bugs. The bugs are all over the place. They happen all the time. Not every single minute that you play. But they happen. They happen. But the game is awesome, it is very enjoyable. But if you plan on playing this game, you have to remember that you will always have bugs. Bugs. I mean, imagine, to give you a perspective. Imagine that in real life, you are starting from point A to go to point B. Point A is here, point B is 100 kilometers away. You start going, traveling to reach point B. At every step in the way, you have flies running around your head, around your face. If you can live with... okay, this is maybe a bit too disgusting, but you get the point, I hope. If you can live with that, then go, travel. You are definitely not 60. Daggerfall has been worked on in Unity Engine. The game is awesome, guys. This game is awesome. The features are very good. The music, you can listen to the music. It is absolutely amazing. Hack and slash games are awesome, but we are not mainstream players. Unfortunately, visit net cafes around the world. Most of the games used to play now, Battle Royale, so no pass. Yeah. Exactly. Both games will never die unless Goth 3 for cut and cuts. You hope it dies slowly. Albadi, you say you are a fan of Gothic games, but you don't like, but you hate actually Gothic 3. How can this be? Forgotten Gods was very buggy, many fans actually hated it. Because of the bugs. Gothic 3 and Gothic 3 Forgotten are separate games. Ah, wait, the Forgotten Gods is the expansion. Is Forgotten Gods a standalone expansion? Yes, Wallen, in this game you have dodging. Actual dodging, you can see animation of dodging. Both enemies and characters can dodge in this game. Blazing Shadow. Ta-da-da. I can legit listen to this music while I play games. Lalouse it is. And the sound effects are very awesome as well. Ta-da-da. Yeah, Wallen, you have skill trees. Let me show you. This is one skill tree. You have four classes in the game, and each class has three different skill trees. This is one skill tree. This is another skill tree. And this is another skill tree. I'm using this skill tree, Artemis, Goddess Artemis. And you put skills down here. You can have 10 hotkeys down here, skills. You have attribute po- Ah! I have 10 points to spend. But you cannot see actually, it is my face there, wait. Yeah, anyway, something like that. This is the attribute points. You can have 10 attribute points. And this is the inventory with the items. Come on, really? Okay, I cannot move like this, not really. I hope you find a game to replay Titan Quest to increase growth, man. Stickab, I don't think I will do that. I cannot, you know, it is not like you can just say that one day, okay, I will start playing this game to make money. You have to like, to really like a game, if you want to work on a channel which you want to make it as a job, but you have to like what you do. Really like what you do. I didn't put so many hours in Titan Quest because there was only the possibility for this thing to grow and become a part-time job. I did it because I truly liked Titan Quest. I cannot sit down and spend what I have done so far with Titan Quest with other games. I cannot do that. Because first I need to play other games and to see if I want to do it with games, to try to do it with games. And to see that truly a game is truly so good and I like it so much that I can spend so many hours working on the game, making videos, live streams, making guides, game guides, build guides and all of these things. If you don't like something so much, if you are not passionate about something, in the end you will fail. You will fail. Now, if this game was being supported still and it didn't have those bugs, I like this game so much that maybe I could do what I have done with Titan Quest with this game as well. This is how much I like this game. But it is not. It is not. I can never do, because it has no support. The game is bugged, totally bugged. It is a dead game, totally dead. So I do not look at things right now. For now, it is just a hobby. And if a miracle happens one day and it grows somehow, the channel, I mean, it grows based on Titan Quest as the main subject of the channel, then if a miracle happens, then everything is fine, all will be good. But right now I'm focusing my most of my efforts to my music channel, my other one. I'm waiting for a new instrument to be released. It is going to be released maybe in 1 or 2 months from now. And my plan is to work on that channel as much as possible with that instrument. And my plan is what I have done with Titan Quest, because I'm truly passionate about Titan Quest, I'm going to do with my other channel with that instrument, because I'm also passionate with keyboards and music, and you know, I will try to do it and see what happens. So it is going to be an investment, the new instrument I'm going to buy. It is a professional instrument. It is going to be an investment, and I will see what will happen. And when it comes to this channel, we'll keep going with Titan Quest. And hopefully one day I will make that book of Titan Quest. I want to make that book. And as I said before, today I got this very awesome idea to create the book, but make it a digital form, not as a PDF only. Make it an interactive book. Something like that would give you the feeling of a video game or something. I will see if I can do something like that. Favorite games from other genres? I have Stalker, Elder Scrolls, what else? Medal of Honor when it comes to first person shooters, but this franchise is dead. Diablo. But you say other genres, so Diablo, yeah, is the same genre. How is the channel going to grow on Titan Quest alone when devs are making your content or updates? Psyche, it is not going to grow. But as I said before, I'm here for Titan Quest. And I'm here because of Titan Quest. I will support this game. I don't know how much longer I will be able to support the game. And after that... I only hope that the other channel will grow in time, as much as this one has grown in time, and because, to be honest, yes, Titan Quest is my favorite video game and all of this stuff, but music, I like music more than video games, to be honest. It is, music is even more creative than video, than making beats and, you know, making things like that in video games, so... If that channel grows as much as this one has grown, then I will be super duper happy. So when it comes to the future, at least to the near future of this channel, we keep doing what we have been doing. We have the live streams and we have videos. Mostly Titan Quest and other RPG games. Nothing changes. Stalker was awesome. It is awesome. The blade doesn't drop. What? Albadi, what do you mean? Do you think you stream on Twitch? It would be great for you and your future. Wallen, I'm always live streaming on Twitch. Right now I'm on Twitch as well. I'm doing multi-streams. Always. At the same time, right now if you go on Twitch, you will see me on Twitch as well. Finally made it to legendary difficulty. I started to get some drops. You hope you can contribute to community tomorrow. Ah, tomorrow is Saturday, yeah. I don't think we will get a game like Titan Quest ever again, not soon. I think, yeah, but no. I'm just saying, put half of your time into something else and see how it does, like your music channel, different questions, if it does well then. Psyche, this is exactly what I'm planning on doing. Exactly, as you said it, this is what I'm planning on doing. And I will see how it will go, and if I will feel like I need more time, more hours, more free hours for the other channel, I will reduce the live stream show for this one. Maybe instead of live streaming 6 days per week, it will be 5 or 4 days per week. Wallen, welcome to the Twitch channel as well. Okay, I have one skill point to spend. I can spend the skill point on this skill. Where is it? Ah, this one. The Volley of Arrows. We have some... I don't have attribute points. Let's go. The best way to do something that you got to do it to grow with this something is to do something that you are truly passionate about. When it comes to video games, Titan Quest is mine, my passion. When it comes to other stuff, keyboards and music. And I have another one, of which I'm going to make a couple of videos. The first one, it will come pretty soon. These videos are mostly philosophical, I would say. They have nothing to... I don't think you have... Actually, okay. These videos are going to be mostly Greek, in Greek. I don't know if I will sit down to translate those things in English and to create English subtitles. I don't know if I will do that. But I'm going to bring a couple of these types of videos. They have nothing to do with games and things like that. Ah! Ooh! Ah! Please, Titan Quest. You could make some bitch videos. How can I make bitch videos? There are always more than one passion. Don't always put all your eggs in one basket if you're not happy or seeing success. Branch out to see what works best. Yeah. You put it very, very nicely. Look, with Titan Quest in this channel, I feel like I have succeeded much more than expected. I never expected to get so many subscribers, for example, in this channel, or to get so many views. The channel right now has more than 4,500,000 views, as far as I remember. Maybe it has reached 5 million, I don't remember. In general, views. So yeah, when it comes, I know that all of these things happened because of Titan Quest, so I feel like this was a total success. At least when it comes to a hobby, right? As a hobby. If you see things from the hobby perspective, this is 100% success. If you don't see it as a hobby, you start seeing things now as... a job, then of course it is not, it is nothing. Hello, Thomas De. Have you found the Dragonborn blade? I haven't found it. As far as I know, this blade do not drop in the normal game. You have to play with mods if you want to get this blade. Mods that allow the blade to drop. What about an unarmed build fire? Unarmed build where, in Titan Quest or in this game? Actually, you're afraid to reach that million followers and need to keep your world dancing naked in the rain. Yosef. Yosef, let me kill this giant phoenix for you. Da-da-da. Da. Do we have any chest? No. I wanted him to do a room tour at one me, it's his own fault. One million. Albati, would you like me to do a room tour at 1 million nude or naked? Possible. It is possible, but I think it is pointless. I don't know if you. I don't think you will reach very far with an unarmed build. This is a pharaoh statue. So, do you like this statue more than the statues of Titan Quest? What do you think? That's hella gay naked, of course. Da-da-da-da. Nice hit, nice hit. Elixir. I need to go and buy we cannot buy elixirs. You need to fight elixirs in this game, you cannot buy them. At least as far as I remember, in a normal difficulty. But, truth be told, I'm still thinking about Elder Scrolls Online. It is Elder Scrolls Games, which is a universe that I like very much. It is a huge game because it is an MMORPG. It looks like an awesome game, deep game with many things to do. And it gets support, constant support, new expansions and whatnot. Sometimes I'm thinking to get that game and give it a try. I think these days it is on 50, it has a 50% discount. Albati, have a good day. Maybe we will see you again someday. If you are committing all your time and effort to a hobby, it no longer becomes a hobby, so you should change the way you view it and maximize the gain of the time you are putting in. Golan, thank you for subscribing on Twitch. Welcome to the line more officially, Golan. Where is a beach? There is a sun. Well, buddy, actually, I have to install the files of this song again on my PC. Work on the piece of music, because it is that a song, the piece of music. And upload somewhere the piece of music so that everybody can hear the music. The son of a bitch. This is the title of the song. The banana sword. In that case, Psyche, I will really need to replace Titan Quest as soon as possible. If I want to keep the way you put it, I mean. This attack is very nice. Opa, let me go. Let me go, let me go, let me go with the flow. Baram, barabam, baram. Zack. Whoa! Did you see that? All of the mummies avoided my projectiles. I have to try this move again. Yes. Some of the enemies in this game are very, very beautiful. Those Phoenix enemies are some of the most beautiful graphics I have ever seen in games in general. Try ESO and see if you enjoy it, but a lot of the content is restricted behind a paywall. That being said, it is 50% off right now only on the base game. Yeah, I know.
Go and buy a beer or two.
Geo-san, thank you for the 2 beers. Donation of 2 beers. Nah, these days I'd rather buy maybe ice cream. By the way, Geo-san, you know, these are the last days of August, maybe. Then September comes, then autumn comes. So I think these days are the... We don't have many chances left to get ice cream or things like that. Purifying potion. Whoa, they stun me. They stun me. Okay, officially now, my damage output is very good. My inventory is full. My damage output is very good. Yeah, armware, delete this item. Let's pick up this one. But what do I need? I need better equipment. I would like to replace my armor items. Oh. Then go and grab many ice creams as possible. Yeah, but you see, on the other hand, we need to do some diet. We don't want to eat so much sugar. You have to avoid sugar. Sugar is killing you. Sugar is killing you softly. Maze of consistency. Delete. You know that the best time and place to eat ice cream is in a cold winter night inside the house near the fireplace. Kyo-san, I have never tried it. Sugar is killing you sweetly. Sweetly and softly. New game. It is not a new game, big bad guy. It is a very old game. This game is 13 years old. Sugar exists in all types of food, if you like it or no. Yeah, this is why you should avoid sugar as much as possible by avoiding ice creams and other sweets. Kedimen. I think they also put sugar and salt, both sugar and salt, in ketchup and mustard, right? If I'm not mistaken. Phoenix, my boy, let me kill you. Whoa, I'm getting killed by elements. Wow. Actually, what I need is resistances. This is why I receive so much damage by elements. This one is stunning me softly, the sucker. I buy the reduced versions of ketchup, nice. Don't know for mustard, I'm sure there is sugar in ketchup. Sugar Daddy. Isn't there a song which is being called Sugar Daddy? Come on, don't kill me. If you stay in a place for a while, you start regenerating life here in this game. Major mana potion. Purifying potion.
Get a pizza.
Gobsy, thank you for the 5 euros of a pizza donation. So, I shouldn't get... wait. Buy a beer or two, get a pizza then. Yes, you can combine beer with pizza. Yosef, what do you say? Could we combine a beer with... two beers with a pizza? Four 10 gold coins. Pharaoh statue. Do we have any chest? No chest. Akhenaton's room, okay. I think there is going to be a boss fight here in this place.
It's been a long time since I've had a visitor. Seth shut me away in this dilapidated tomb to put an end to my glorious line of descent. I, who shared the power of the gods, who placed Aton on high.
Akhenaton!
I am the only pharaoh to be an equal of the gods, to regain immortality.
This is a pharaoh. Okay then. This is a boss fight. I'm fighting Akhenaton, the pharaoh. Let me use some other skills. I get a thanks for the 5 euros of an ice cream. After hours ice cream. Okay, then today we have to drink 2 beers while eating pizza, and after that we have to buy an ice cream. Oh. Can I kill this pharaoh, the dead pharaoh, without getting killed, please? Come and die! I can't. No! You do not use meteors on me.
Surpass my own. My soul can finally be laid to rest.
Thank you. 5 blue items. After the higher tier of this tier is the unique tier. These blue items are the best magical items in the game. The best magical tier of items in the game. After that, you get unique items. You get orange, these ones. The problem now is that I don't have where to put... Toxeus,
Ring of Glory.
No! What did I do? Ring of Glory! Ring of Wit. Where is Ring of... Ring of Wit. Delete. Yes, okay. Pick up the Ring of Glory. Level 40? Come on! Why level... This is level 10. This... Anyway, I did it. This is a very nice place, Akhenaten's room. Aha! And this is a sepulcher. I just picked up Osiris' body. One of the parts of Osiris. Now, the resurrection of Osiris. Fight the lower half of Osiris' body. In the Sphinx room, we have to go to inside the Sphinx and fight the room of the Sphinx and retrieve the body. The head is hidden in a pyramid. The top half lies in a forgotten tomb, and the lower half is in a hidden temple, guarded by a Sphinx. Yeah, but how do we go there? Ice cream fudge increase, mandatory to grab ice cream today. It does exist. 2014 was a movie called Sugar Daddies. Yosef, you have teleport. You click this button and you can teleport to all of these places that you unlock. The game is awesome, guys, and it is. I cannot believe that how this game is dead. I still cannot believe the game is so awesome. Come on, give me the skill. Die, die, die! Yes, nice. Okay, actually, I have to go back to the city to get rid of all of the items I have. Because I cannot pick up any more items. Village. It is a village. It is not a city. The Sarasan village. Dun, 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 dun. I have to go. Wait, if I talk to Isis, nothing. This is the altar of your gods. Let's go. Ah, wait, wait, wait. I have to see first if I have any upgrades, weapons. Do I have a better bow? No. Bah. Better armor? No. Huh. Yes. Okay, now we offer these items to the gods and we gain faith experience points. By gaining faith experience points, I can also offer unique items if I want. And unique items provide much more faith than other lower tier of items. But to be honest, I want to keep the unique items, even though... Yeah, I will keep the uniques. I will make a collection. Greek boots. Warhammer of Tears. Nice name. Level up. You level up by offering items to the gods. But it is only the skill tree level up. It is not your characters. I always liked this feature in this game. Short bows. Oops, no. Offer the short bows. Okay, yeah. I have my bow, I have my shield, and my. These items are unique, so everything is fine now. Ah! Now I can go back to... Ah, wait, where is the store? I want to go to the store, sell a couple of items. Sell kiosk. Purifying potion. Okay. Let's go back. Keep unique items. Yosif, I will. I will keep the unique items. Unfortunately, in this version of Steam, there is no way to transfer your unique items from one character to another. I tried to fight, and I found the official tool the developers had created back in the day for the game, with which you could store as many items as you'd like with that tool, and you could also transfer those items between your characters. Actually, that tool is exactly what Titan Quest Vault is for Titan Quest, but it is official. The problem is that I installed the tool here in my PC, but it doesn't work with the Steam version. So, I cannot transfer my items to other characters, which is very bad. Imagine if you find some very good unique items for other classes, that would be good for other classes, other characters anyway, and you would like to give these items to the other characters to make even better builds. You cannot. You cannot. The only way for me to do that now would be to install Windows XP in my laptop and install the game. Not this version of the game of Steam, the old version, the non-Steam version of the game, in my laptop and install the tool there. With Windows XP it would work. But and I could take the save files from here, put the same files there in that version of Windows XP, transfer the items between characters, and then take the files from there and put them here and keep playing. Yeah, unfortunately it is useless, yes. At least for Steam version. I don't know, Yosef, if it works on Windows 10. Because I'm also using Windows 10. Maybe that tool was made back in the day for it was working back in Windows XP, maybe even Windows Vista or Windows 7. But back then there was no Windows 10, so I don't know. Anyway, technically I can do it. I can install Windows XP in my laptop, and, but I would need also to download the non-Steam version of the game, install it there. Have this problem on Dungeons & Dragons 2 on Steam. Wallet? What problem? You cannot transfer items between characters on Dungeons & Dragons 2. It doesn't cost me nothing. It costs time. This is what it costs. Time. Only time. But yeah, look, Yosef, if I knew that I would be playing this game constantly for a longer time, I would probably do that because it would be awesome. But I don't think I will be playing this game for a long time. I don't know. This is a skeleton chief. This is the chief of the tribe of skeletons. Nan, the camera. What do you mean, Nan, the camera? You have a problem on Dungeons & Dragons with the camera of the game. The zoom camera on Vertigo Ion physical CD I don't have, but I have lost my CD 1 or 2. Aha! Yeah, you could probably download it. I mean, if you have already bought a game, I see no problem if you go to download the game as well from a torrent. I mean, you have already bought the game. Right, so it is not really cheating if you download a game from a torrent in a digital form when you have already bought a game. Dun 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 d Yosef, what do you think of this game that I'm playing right now? Do you like it, as you see it? Do you think that you would ever play this game? Nice, blue item. Oh, nice, many items. I have lost my CD, one of two, so I downloaded the version on Steam, and now I have camera problems. That way is better to explain. Yeah, it is better. In the Steam forums, in the Steam forums of Adagio Seeds 2, I think there is a topic where they talk about downloading unofficial patches for Dungeon Switch 2 that can fix some of the problems of the game. Have you checked the forums of Steam page of Dungeon Switch 2? I like what I see, too bad have some ugly bugs. Yeah. On Grim Dawn I have a Night King built Necropet. Night King build Necropet. Night King. Night King is a Necromancer and Oathbreaker. I don't remember the classes of Grim Dawn. Come on, Skeleton Chief, give me a unique item or something good. Unique item, I mean. Edge, come on, Chief. Come on, Chief. We don't want you as our Chief. You are not our Chief anymore. Give me a good item. For EX to not can pick up items and items collectioner on all games. You see, if you can still make a collection, I mean, if you make if you find the unique items, you can hold the items in your current character and make a collection on that character. Of course, this is not the best thing because in this game there is no stats. No stats. And this is why I have these unique items here. I don't use these items. I don't want to get rid of these items because these are uniques. And I hold them in my inventory because there is no stats in this game. Hello, MSA. Yeah, MSA, in this game you can make many builds, yes. The chief has run out of calcium. Yeah, the skeleton one. No stas. Yeah, no stas, Yosef. That tool I was talking about, it works as a stas, external stas. You can save as many items as you like there, and you also transfer the items between characters. You can also transfer gold between characters with that tool. But this is the problem, it doesn't work with the Steam version, and I don't know if it even works in Windows 10, I don't know. I mean, if you install the non-Steam version, will that tool work on Windows 10? I have no clue. It is the same. This game is very... The fate of this game was very bad. Very unfortunate. Game of Thrones. Pick up this one. I agree, but reclaim time for transferring with a stats, things are much faster, yes. Pet Vital build. Wallen, are you playing in Grim Dawn with a pet build that deal vitality damage? Your builds, your pets deal vitality damage or your character? Nightmare from the Yod is dead. Purifying potion, come on, I want to find elixirs. Elixirs are the best potions in this game because they heal you from all illnesses, all status of effects, and also they give you life, regenerate your life. Level up! Finally! Ring of Endurance and my inventory is full. Maybe I should go and sell some runes. Come on, give me something good! Skeleton Chief! Ah! No! Useless! Chief, you are useless! Can you have pets? Yes, Yusuf, in this game you can have pets, but not many pets. I think... I don't remember, I think only two classes can have pets here. I don't remember. Walt Dade says, sorry, but you are gay. No. Should I be? Do you want me to become gay? Have you tried any fate expansions? MS, are you referring to the hack and slash fate games? Those games are very nice. No, I talk about the beat that I have on Grim Dawn that we were talking about earlier. Ah. Ta-da-da. The Table of Sphinx. The RX RPG. Yes, I know MSA. I have played Fate games. I have played the first one and the Fate game, and I have tried the second one, which was Fate. Not the Traitor Souls. The Traitor Souls. Here you must find an item right. Yes, Yusuf. I will tell you. Yes, I have to fight two items. Here I will fight. I need to fight the lower half of Osiris' body and the head of Osiris. I don't know if these two items. Ah, no. They are not here in this room. I mean in this map. Here's Trend Traitor Soul. Yeah. And the third one, how do they call the third expansion? I think the third expansion, it says something like Kings of King, something King with King. My bow is very good. Wait. I have 1 point to spend. I will go with critical hit. No, I could go with volley of arrows, or I could increase my mastery of bows. The mastery of bows provides more physical damage and bonus to accuracy. What should I do? Or should I increase the volume of arrows for this skill to be dealing more damage? Or should I increase the critical hit to be dealing more critical damage? Critical hits. Let's go with physical damage. Cursed King. Yeah, Fate the Cursed King. Something like that. Have you played these games, MSA? In Loki, can critical hit with ranged weapons? Yes, Yusuf. You can, yes. When you see. Now, you can see, I guess, in the screen. The red numbers are critical hit. It says critical hit. When it says critical hit, this means you deal critical damage. You have tried it, it is like Mythos. Ah, so you have also tried Mythos. Nice. Yeah, I remember Mythos. Unfortunately, that game, it died very, very, very fast. I think it was in beta version when they terminated the game. Take a look at this statue. Do you like it? This looks great. And we have one more. Ring of luck, they say. Yeah. Do I look like lucky to you? Four % increased chance to fight more powerful items. Well, not very good. Does this have elemental affliction? Fire damage will be more lethal against Ice Master. Yes, there are. Let me show you. Can you see? Yes, you can see. Resistances tab up here. All of these things down here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, are resistances. Fire, cold, lightning, dark, and poison. This is dark damage or something like that. And you also have changes of state, which is slowed, wicked, blinded, stupid. I don't know what stupid does. Sick, exhausted, frail, deficient, vulnerable, deranged, frightened, restricted, silenced, cursed, mana drain, wounded, fallen, knockout. Five resistances and many changes of state. So you have fire damage over time, poison damage over time. Maybe here we will have a boss fight. I mean the room of Sphinx. Let's take a look. Yes. Where is the boss? This is... Ah, Sphinx! This is a boss Sphinx. This boss looks very nice. But sorry boss, I'm here to kill you. You can never escape my wrath. Whoa! This was knocked down. I was hoping for a unique item. Come on, boss. I just picked up the lower half of Osiris's body. Now I need to fight the head of Osiris, which is the last item, before we can put together the body of Osiris. You know, this is a true Egyptian mythology. It is one of the stories of Egyptian mythology. The body of Osiris, which now you have to fight the different parts of the body, put them together. Is it like confusion in Pokemon where you can do to the... Kyo-san, to be honest, I don't remember seeing this stupid effect. It is probably confusion, yeah. Because it says nothing about confusion here. Maybe stupid is confusion. Saber of Osiris. There are three more problems. The head is in a pyramid, the top. The head is hidden in a pyramid. I have to go to a pyramid now. How do I go there? Pyramid of Cheops? No, I will go to the plateau of Giza. Yosef, these are Osiris items, are quest items. How is the multiplayer? I don't know. MS. I have never played multiplayer here in this game. I don't know if it works. Have you finished the story campaign in this game? Yeah, Kyosan, years ago. Yes. I have spent some good hundreds of hours in this game. Not many. Maybe 100 hours, maybe 200 hours. Back in the day, I was playing this game. Gold coin. Ah, Kyosan, your time. Okay, I will show you. I will go right now in that chamber, your time. And you will see. Okay. Let me kill these enemies first. So, in this game, this is the waypoint system. You click down here, portal, and you get these places where you can transfer if you want. You have four acts. You have Norse act, I haven't played the Norse act yet. Aztec, Egyptian, and Greek. And you have beyond time. Thresholds of time. You go there. MS, this game has some skills that come from Diablo. It has Whirlwind, it has maybe a couple more, I don't remember. But it has new skills as well. It is not a clone of Diablo, it is much different. So, here you are. How do you gain access to this place? Well, when you start a character, you start in one of the four different acts depending on what class you choose. I chose the Greek fighter and it started in the Greek act, so I played this one. When you finish the first act of the campaign, the game takes you to beyond time. Here. Here you can see you have four different portals. 1, 2, 3, 4. These portals are portals of the four acts of the game. So, after you finish the first act with your character, you come here and you select which will be the next act that you will play at. You can go wherever you want. After I finished Greek and I came here, I chose to continue in Egyptian act. If I wanted, I could go to Aztec instead of Egyptian. So, the game takes you here and you choose from this place to go to Heraklion village. If I want to go to, this is the Greek act, the village of the Greek act. This is the Thorden village, which is the village of Norse Act. This is Saracen village, which is Egyptian Act, and this is the Tula village, which is the Aztec Act. Right now, if I would, I can go to Thornton village or Tula village and start playing also the acts at the same time of the other acts. But I'd rather finish Egyptian Act, because I have my portal activated there after all. And it is better to finish one act and then go to the other, because you have some main quests in each one of the acts, but you have a couple of side quests as well. And if you want to complete everything, it is better to finish an act and then go to another. Which means, after I complete Egyptian Act, I can choose if I go to continue on Aztec or Norse Act. Also, after you play all acts, I think from this place you get another portal, and it takes you to the next difficulty level straight away. There is something more that you do here, but I don't remember, because I haven't played for many years and I don't remember. Yeah, Kyo-san, it is a gateway, yeah. One of you choose, you must finish the act or you can change your mind. You can change your mind, you can go to another act and finish the other act and then go back to continue the other act. Yosef. But I got to take acts one by one, because it is easier this way. To avoid confusion. I told you, this game has some great ideas. Some of the features of this game are super duper awesome. This is why I say it is a shame that the game is not fixed. The bugs are not fixed. Quality of life improvements are not here. The company is not working on the game. It is a shame. The game is worth it. It is totally worth it. But I think I will play this character at least and, until I reach the third difficulty level, which means I will show you somehow. Maybe I will make videos and I will show you what happens when you finish all acts of the game. What happens with that place, the Beyond Time. Ah, I remember now, there is a video, small video that plays after you finish the first difficulty level at least. And in that video, I think if I remember correctly, you meet Kronos himself, the Titan Kronos. And Kronos saves you. He saves your life. But I don't remember details. Three difficulty levels. MSA, I don't know about the Dungeon Switch 3 multiplayer. This is the pyramid. Do you play the Hell or Doom 2, by the way? The Hell mod of Diablo 1. No. I don't play these games because I don't have time to play so many games. I mean, I'm still thinking of making a series of videos of Diablo 1 playthrough, but I don't know when I will find time to do that. The maximum level, Yosef, is 200. 200. Is this game more fun than Titan Quest in your opinion? If the game didn't have all of these bugs, it would be... Look, Titan Quest is better in general. Overall, it is better. It is also more fun. But what is super duper fun in this game for me personally is that this game feels mostly like a slaughterhouse, because especially many big maps of the game, they provide hundreds of enemies. And if you want, you can go kill all of these hundreds of enemies. Or if you want, you kill some and you go through the campaign. It is up to you to decide. So yeah, this is what is better in this game in comparison to Titan Quest. This game feels like a slaughterhouse. Titan Quest, it is a great action RPG. It doesn't feel like a slaughterhouse. And also in this game you have blood, which makes the game, you know, more mature. And also you have boobs, which makes the game more mature. So, if this game didn't have all of the bugs that it has, and if it had a couple of quality of life improvements, then I would say that the game would be as fun as Titan Quest is. I would say it is a step below Titan Quest. It is an amazing game. The bugs are killing the game. No, it is nothing like Path of Exile, no. This game is very similar to Titan Quest, not Path of Exile. This is why I have always considered this game to be the dark side of Titan Quest. Because it is darker, the atmosphere is darker, it is more mature, there is blood, there is nudity. In Titan Quest you don't have these things. Ουα, σολάμια και κασέρια. Heavy Greek arm piece, blah. Da-da-da-da. Obviously, we need a Titan Quest DLC with naked Amazons. Yeah, yeah. Currently playing Poe, a game is better than ever. I don't know, maybe. I don't play Poe. Maybe it is. Are you enjoying the news, the league, the Harvest League?
Mm-hmm.
Titan Quest could use some blood effects. Yeah. It could, but I don't see that happening. Just wait for POE 2. A POE 2 is going to be a big expansion for POE 1. It is not going to be a different game. It will have some improvements, of course, but it is expansion. Awesome crafting. They even censored the woman with the snakes in Titan Quest that you go to have ancestor to Amazons. Yeah, Elamude. Yeah, in Titan Quest this will never happen. But look, I don't care about nudity in Titan Quest. I would like to have blood though. But even blood is not important. What is important in Titan Quest is other things. The most important thing is to fix the bugs. And of course to release the controller patch. What would you compare POE 2 to Last Epoch? I mean, Titan Quest has nude mods on Nexus. Shops at stores with cigarettes, beers, tavern music and junk food. In Titan Quest, Yusuf. Do you got all of these things in Titan Quest? A skeleton lord! A skeleton lord! Oh my lord! My lord is here, he's trying to kill. Opa! This lord deals damage! This lord is not even kidding! Come here, skeleton lord! Eh? What is the weapon? Ah, this is a different bug. Okay. Don't tell me I have. Where the fuck is my weapon? When did I really? When did I unequip my weapon? This game has quite the sound design. The sound design is perfect. The sound design of this game is perfect. The atmosphere of the game is perfect as well. The corridors of Forgotten Tomb. The Forgotten Tomb. Wow. Awesome killing. Really? Skeleton Lord. Rune of Luck, eh? Wait. Do I have any runes of luck? Luck. I don't have runes of luck. Really? You can attach runes on your items and you can get buffs and whatnot from the runes. I think the rune of luck provides magic fight. Let me see. Rune of luck. Rune. Where is rune of luck? Rune of luck. 5% decreased chance to fight more powerful items. Yeah. It goes to boots, only footwear items. Each one of the runes can be used on specific types of items. Elixir! Finally! Bye bye, Golem! I will see you tomorrow, probably, Golem. Have a good day. Slowing Sacrum. Hey, come on now, zombie. How can you dodge so many attacks of mine? You are just a zombie. Who do you think you are, Legolas? One more elixir. Perfect. Run like the wind. Ta ta ra ta ra ta ra ta 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 ra ta ra ta ta ta. Another nice thing here is the sound for dropped items. Yes, Yusuf. And you know, the higher the tier of item that drops, the different the sound is. different the sound is. You get a different sound for a higher tier of items. What is that? The Chamber of Osiris! I think there is one more boss here. I think we kill the boss and we retrieve the head of Osiris. No. I have to run down there. Okay, let's do it. Da-da-da-da. Aman! I don't have major health potions. I need to go and buy major health potions. This guy sells potions, yeah. No, MSA, this game is an isometric top-down game, it is not third person. Buy, sell, kiosk. Saber of Osiris. I wasn't expecting this saber to be such a corridor. But anyway, it is always fun and very satisfying killing enemies in this game. Mana potion! No, 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 no. Ring. Are there any other scrolls, hack and slash mods? No, I don't think so. Disc of vulnerability. Do you know that in this game the discs are thrown weapons? This game actually has thrown weapons. Have you ever played Metin 2? Nope, I haven't. Discs by the nature are throwing. Yeah. This is the effect of frightened. It is a scary mummy. This evil mummy is very scary. Oh, nice hit. Okay, this was a good one. We are getting closer and closer to Osiris's head. One more evil mummy.
Hmm.
Here we are, what is that? Evil mummy? Τσακ τσακ! Mana potion, don't go the mana potion. Give me these things. Whoopa! Whoa! Blue ring of luck! Wow! Wait, where is the rings? The rings, the rings, the rings. Ring of luck, ring of effortlessness. This is very good actually. So destroy this one. And the blue provides increased chance for percent health drain 3% at 19 mana points. Very nice. Okay, this is a good drop. Here we are. Osiris head, perfect. Έλα ρε, chest, come on chest. You know, this specific chest is a high quality chest. But unfortunately, I got nothing. Take the parts of Osiris' body to Isis. Isis, let's go to Isis. You go to Sarasan village. Loading the game. If only they optimize this game and they fix the bugs. Okay. Let's talk to the other guy. Is he going to give us a quest or something? Nope, no quest. When it comes to side quests in this game, you don't get many per act. You get up to 2 or 3 per act, not more. Fire, you played maybe Paladin with a bow. No, Artorias, I haven't played. Why? Is it possible to play Paladin with a bow? Ring of Glory, Ring of Luck, this one requires level 40, I am level 39 level. Take a look how close I am to level up, in both XP bars, Faith bar and Heroes bar. The Book of the Dead in the Valley of the Kings, the Tombs in the Valley of the Kings. Yeah, but how do you go there? Gate of the Kings, from there you can reach Anubis Black Pyramid. Yeah, I don't remember anyway. You can. Artorias, after I'm done with my Amazon with a 200 tax, maybe I will play a Bugs Bunny Barbarian with a 200 mace. This is what I'm thinking of doing in Diablo 2. Bugs Bunny Barbarian with a 200 mace. When I say Bugs Bunny, I mean that I will be using the skill, not the leap, the other one. Which leaps, barbarian jabs, and he hits enemies and deals damage. I will probably do something like this. But first I have to finish my first build, which is in epic difficulty, nightmare difficulty now, not epic. And it is doing okay, it is doing well for now, I would say. So guys, this is it. I'm stopping here for tonight. This game is so awesome. So awesome. It is so addicting. The music is so amazing. The music alone makes you wanting to keep playing the game. I wish I knew how to program things, stuff, maybe a programming language, so that I could work on this game and make some unofficial patches myself. Yosif, you too, have a good one. Everybody, thanks for watching the stream. Tomorrow is Saturday, we play tomorrow Titan Quest multiplayer and we give items away. So, I will probably see you tomorrow. Also, thanks for supporting the stream with donations. So everybody have a good one. This game is awesome. If you have it in your collection, play this game, give it a try, and I will see you tomorrow again. Kyo-san, have a good one. Yeah, bye bye, Angele.